Welcome to Norfolk Perspective City Slice. I'm Bob Batcher, and I got one of my favorite guests on the sofa, Kelly Welsh, who knows nothing about flowers, but she works at the garden. Is that true?
No, that's not true. You do know some stuff about flowers.
I know
some, but I'm certainly not the expert in that, for sure.
Okay, well, you brought some spring to the table. So what did you bring?
I brought daffodils, and this is a Cuba. I do know that. This plant, the green leaf, is a Cuba, and I picked those today, or cut them, I should say.
From the garden?
From the garden.
Isn't that kind of early?
It's probably a little bit early, but we've had a lot of warm days, and they're trying to make their way. Spring's coming.
Okay, now, did you have to get permission to cut those? I mean, you can't just go to the garden and cut flowers.
No. I work there,
well,
Bob,
so
I'm allowed. It's okay to bring this to your studio today.
Okay, good. But you have to take them back.
No, you guys can have it. It's a present for you.
Look, you're still having fun, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
It's a fun place?
It is. It's a great place. It's beautiful and a lot of great people to work with, and I love the guests, and yeah, it's a great place.
It's really serious. I mean, you have classes, you teach things. It's a serious place, though, isn't it?
Yeah, we offer a lot. We certainly do. We have a lot of things going on. It's February, and it's our February fun month, so come on out to the garden for $5.
Huh?
And you can ride your bike.
Five? That's it?
$5, yep.
But everything's dead.
No, there's tons to
see. Well, no, dormant, I guess, is probably a better way to look at it.
Maybe, yeah, some dormant. You might find a few camellias right now and some daffodils that are trying to make their way through. There's lots of trees with interesting bark and lots to see all year long.
Okay, can we rewind a little bit?
Yes.
Because the last time I was at the garden, I was walking 2 miles. It was about 55 degrees, and I was looking at, God, felt like millions of lights. Are they still there?
They are pretty much done. I'm pretty sure I haven't seen any light displays for a little while. They're down, and they're in a new building. We have a new building where they're going to be stored.
Are they
going to
come back?
So that's exciting.
Yes,
of course. 2014 is our 20th anniversary for our light show, for our Dominion Garden of Lights. And we're super excited. We're getting a brand new front display with Dominion in it. And there's some new exciting things that I can't really talk about.
Come on, tell me.
There's going to be some exciting displays or something. They haven't quite worked that out, but there's going to be some new stuff.
You're going to come back and tell me?
Sure, absolutely.
Okay, but let me be real candid with you, because I've had some people say, must not have been very good this year because they didn't have the major backups they've had in previous years.
You know what?
The numbers are up, right?
we had a very good year. We had a parking crew and a light crew combined this year. And I think it was pretty organized.
We
got through it. I worked a couple nights myself, and it got quite busy.
Well, I actually went through twice because I walked through one time, and then I couldn't resist. We had friends over, and as soon as we got on the park, it was one of those nights that was beautiful, and I dropped the top on the car, and it was awesome.
Yeah, we had definitely some warm nights, and we had quite a few people do that. So
it was really cool.
That's fun, yeah.
Okay, but February.
February fun month, so get in for $5, and you can ride your bike every day all month long from 9
to
5.
Oh,
so
cool.
I know it's a little cold, but we certainly have had some warm days.
You can kind of meander.
Yeah, take your time, ride your bike, take pictures. Obviously, the garden is a great place
for photographers. There are paths that really kind of hit the whole garden, right?
Yes. Yeah, we have 12 miles, actually, of paved pathways.
I wasn't going to ask you that question because I didn't know if you knew the answer.
No, I do know that, yes.
12 miles?
12 miles, if you were to put them all together. But,
right.
And then there's trails that are not, don't have pavement. So, there's lots to do at the garden.
12 miles.
Yeah.
I'm coming out on a Saturday. That
sounds
cool.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so you got some classes starting.
We have lots of classes. We have an exciting class called By the Yard, and a national author, Doug Talamay, is going to be there
as a keynote
speaker, and he's the author of Bringing Nature Home. And people are really excited about that. And it's all about, you know, the environment and learning about buffers if you live on the water. And even if you don't live on the water, what can you do to help the environment and help our waterways?
So it's really kind of, and it's moving more toward a natural look rather than that English garden formal thing,
yeah,
right?
And we'll have experts. We'll have a panel discussion and people speaking, experts. We've partnered with the City of Norfolk and other organizations, so we're pretty excited about that. Everything is on our website. There's a printable PDF. and information about it. So certainly if you're interested, come on out.
Okay, well, Kelly, I let you off the hook when I said that you don't know much about it, because I'm dying to find out, when can I prune my rose bushes? I can't ask you that, can I?
Actually, well, I know it's done in the winter months. I think you can prune a different, and I'm kind
You're
of speaking out of
trouble.
My...
Yeah. But
they are already pruned. They are already pruned right now, so I can tell you that. They're pruned way down.
Oh, so I ought to go home
down.
Right now and prune mine? Or call
I don't know.
At the garden.
You could definitely call on the garden, but I know that they
can
are pruned
right now.
Can you
ask those kind of
right
questions
now.
When you're walking around the garden?
Yeah. And we have someone at the front desk all the time, and if we don't know the answer, we have experts there that will answer that for
so
you.
So just because you cut daffodil doesn't necessarily mean you know how to prune a rose bush.
I am not an expert. I look to the experts
there
at our
and
garden for
so
answers
what are the kind
all
of
the time.
How about exercise classes? You still doing those?
We have exercise classes. We have yoga, Pilates. We have all kinds of classes that you might not think of a garden having.
So it's not just about azaleas.
No, we have guitar lessons. We do have gardening. We have mosaic classes. We have cooking classes. Almost anything that you could think of.
And the flower, the infamous flower.
Yeah.
Because you took a class, didn't you? Because I couldn't do that.
No, I had someone that helped me
that
a little bit.
On.
Betty Ann, who comes on here sometimes.
Yeah.
She's great. She does a lot.
It's remarkable what she can do with a twist tie.
Yeah.
Something I can't do.
Yeah, absolutely. And we do have something very exciting with orchids, talking about flowers, at our tropical house. So sort of take a trip, if you will, to the tropics and visit our tropical house. We have a winter orchid display where there's 150 or so orchids. Exciting to see them. They're beautiful. We've partnered with ODU. As well as the Tidewater
cool.
Orchid Society.
That's right, because they've got a big conservatory.
Yeah.
ODU, don't they?
And we also have an orchid class coming up, so people interested in a orchid class and how to grow them, certainly get in touch with
somebody
us.
Somebody gave me an orchid for a gift one time.
Yeah, they're kind of particular.
I can't invite that person over to my house ever again because the orchid's not there anymore.
Well, that's coming up in February 21st, so definitely check out our website
have
for that.
Write that one down, Ned. February 21st?
Because
they really are cool.
Yeah, they're beautiful. 23rd. And in the tropical house, there's most of them are hybrids. So they're combinations of different orchids, and they're just stunning.
Stunning. Now, we were talking today, the art that's in the garden. You just got done with a major redo of the statuary.
Yeah, area. It looks beautiful. The statues are gorgeous.
So even this time of year, it's a good place to kind of just come out
yeah,
and
yeah, absolutely.
$5 a day.
$5. And if you haven't been to the garden in a long time, you don't have a membership, come on out. $5.
Well, I was going to say, mentioned membership, because I know a cheaper way you can go.
Yeah, the membership is, a family membership is certainly the way to go. It's $85 a year, and that is for six people, which includes yourself and family members or family friends.
Or people you could pack in the car.
Yeah, it's certainly worth it. You come as many times as you want.
Okay, now you put together an event last year that I just find to be totally awesome.
Yeah.
You set fire to water.
Yes.
You did. You're going to do it again this year?
Yes. Aqua Fire is back by popular demand. We did it for the first time in November, and we are bringing it back Friday, March 21st.
Now, you want to explain what that was?
Yeah, we have.
Not everybody can set fire to water.
Yeah, we have in our Renaissance Court, which is a beautiful setting, there is a pond area, our Renaissance pond, and we put fire pits actually in the water. So it was fire on the water. So fire water, that's where we got the aqua fire. And we had wine and beer, and we had music. So it was just a really great time.
And it wasn't at the guitar class. Coming over to practice.
No. No. We had a musician, and we had a few musicians out there playing, so it was really a really good time. People really enjoyed it. Brought chairs and blankets and just kind of had like a, you know, like you would do sort of at your home in a backyard fire pit in a beautiful setting. So it was a really casual but beautiful.
And see, it's so much easier to do at your place than having it at my place where I have to find the twigs and keep the fire going.
And then you don't have to worry about it. We do all the cleanup. And plus, we had a lot of lights that led the way to Renaissance Court. So it was a little walk to the court. Yeah, very pretty.
Okay,
so
now,
people can make that out.
I mean, it's the winter time, so I really thought you guys would take the month, you know, the couple of months off. You came off a very successful. Does this mean you're taking spring off? You got stuff coming up in the spring?
No, we have tons of things going on all the time. And certainly our gardeners and curators, the hort staff, they're working nonstop all the time.
Because even though things are in a dormant stage, there's life there, but there's also Cultivating the future life.
There is something to see all year long. Certainly spring is what people think of, roses and different flowers and things like
that.
But
there's
something.
The azaleas.
And the azaleas.
When do they start popping up?
They're coming up March, April time period. Depending on the weather, sometimes the weather will push them back or push them forward a little bit.
Now, how about the butterflies?
The butterflies, we're going to have our butterfly house and something exciting with our summer exhibit this
year. Yeah,
I'm going to have to come back. We are going to, let me just give you a little teaser.
I'm such
teaser.
A failure as a journalist.
We are going to try to help the monarch.
You're going to help the monarch?
We're going to try to help the monarch with what we're doing with our summer exhibit. And
now, when you say
people,
monarch,
your
you
viewers
don't mean
at home can do that, too.
And when you say the ones with the little wings.
Butterflies have wings.
Butterflies.
Yes.
No, not the lion.
Monarch butterflies. Yes.
You're going to help? We're going to kind of encourage
Yeah,
them?
People could, yes, viewers and, yeah, guests of the garden can help. So some exciting things to talk about next time.
See, you wouldn't sandbag Andy Fox, but me, you will.
No.
Can you come back on?
Yes, absolutely. I'll come back on.
So if you haven't been out to the garden in the last couple of weeks, get out there now because it's brand new. That's what's really
kind
of changing.
Yeah, it is ever changing. I've been there for a year and a half. Came on when I first started working in the garden. And every time I go out in the garden, I'm like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize that was here. So something to discover every single time I come out.
Kelly, thanks for being a good sport.
Thank you.
This is awesome. And thank whoever made that arrangement for you because it's gorgeous.
Well, I did, but I had some assistance.
Okay, cool. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us.